This, ladies and gentlemen, is the free rack 48U that I picked up just before Christmas. It is a 30-inch deep, 40U high. Manufacture is made by Hammond Manufacturing. Might be a Quebec, Montreal-based manufacturer. I'm not too sure on that one. Nice glass door, tinted, lockable. And inside, I put an RGB light because this is right next to my home theater. So it's nice to see this all lit up at night. So up here is a QNAP 659 Pro that hosts 12 terabytes of storage in iSCSI. A nice, it's just a gigabit switch. It's an HP Enterprise model, works great. Patch panel, which I've just installed recently, so I'm still trying to figure out my wiring runs. The switch sucks because it doesn't go all the way here, so I can't make use of these ports without buying longer patch panel cables. These are all 6-inch blue ones that I picked up off of Amazon. I have a fiber line going from here right up to my kids' play area. They have their gaming computers there, so I'm running switch to switch with a fiber line, a 10 gig fiber line. Below that is a Dell R610, currently not in use. I just got the RAID card, but the cables that I got are too short. And top it all off, when I installed the cables that came from a 710, hoping it would fit the 610, I end up damaging the back plane on the back of the board. Luckily, it's $20 to change, so for now, once I get that new part in, I'll make a video on swapping out the back plane on this unit and get it up and running. This will eventually be my pfSense firewall for routing at home. I'm right now using a slim form factor Dell desktop computer that's on the floor behind my rack, which I'll show you in a little bit. And it's serving the purpose as my firewall, but I really want to get it rack mounted. These are the rails for my Dell, my Insilon NL400, nice thick, solid beefy rails. So I'm looking forward to putting that back in here after I got it all nice and quiet. Some random hardware. In the meantime, I just have to do a little cleanup. I have a 400 gigabyte internet at home, 400 down, 50 up, with Tech Savvy Canada. Thumbs up. You guys are awesome. The best service ever. Nope, not sponsored video, but I highly recommend them if you live in my area. And I've got a Microtech CRS-305 5-port 10 gigabit switch there. I'll get some better light in here so I can take a look, show you later on. Below this, I've got two HP ML350P Generation 8. These are they're fantastic servers. They are so quiet. I really highly recommend them. This one's only got a 6-core and another 6-core here below. This one's currently off. I'm using it just for backup for now. I'm running, these are only 1 terabyte SAS drives, so 6 terabytes here. This is doing my Xpinology virtual machines running on EXSI, as well as I've got a FreeNAS running on there, sharing about 3 or 4 terabytes of these drives here via iSCSI. So I run 2 iSCSI drives to give extra storage on my home network. The one below it is identical to this one, except I don't have any hard drives except for 2 terabytes that are in here. And guys, I looked everywhere to find these legacy form factor LFF 6-bay drives. Can you imagine how much these cost? This costs on eBay? You're looking at about $500 to $600 Canadian, and I've seen them up to $1,000 Canadian just for the drive cage. I can't believe it. I absolutely can't believe it. I want to make use of this server. I thought about taking out this one and putting it here. I did get the cable that splits the power from the motherboard to the cage, which is great. $20 on eBay for some knockoff one, because the original one is about $150 from HP just to do that. And then I'm all missing now is a another RAID card to run this second drive bay, because I can't run this one and this one. From what I read online, it's got to have its own controller, and this one's got to have its own controller. Don't ask me why. I'm no expert in SAS and in backplanes and RAID controllers. So anyway, so I'm taking my time. I'm in no rush. Below that, I have it is APC Smart UPS 2200 RT. This is fantastic. It's got no load on it with everything running, and as well, it's got its spare battery backup. I don't believe the batteries are good in here. I just acquired this whole rack just before Christmas. I finally got this running. I had to change out the batteries. Even if the batteries are dead, this shows no signs of life. So once the batteries are swapped out and reassembled, by the way, I tried testing this with the cover off, with the faceplate off. No bueno, no power. So all I did was reassemble it, put the cover back on, put in the new batteries, and Bob's your uncle, I got power again. So this one here, there is no lights or anything to tell me the status of this one. This one's got six more 12 volt batteries in it, and this one's got three 12 volt batteries in it. Actually, it's four 12 volt batteries and then four and four. So in total of 12 batteries just to run backup. So, it's got a fan inside of this unit as well. This is a noisy fan. It's I think it's 200 millimeter. So I'm gonna have to find a solution here to replace the fan for my server because the walls are on. So it gets a little bit warm in here. I do leave the back door open, which leads under my staircase that goes upstairs. But then this fan here, you'll hear it throughout the whole house. So I have to find another solution that makes it, a lot more bearable for my house. Okay, so this is just a little server rack review. I highly recommend it. I think it looks great in the basement. This is my basement. My office is there that has my Insulin server that's running. You can hear it probably from the background. This laundry room, nothing special. And this is where I put my server rack. All right. Well, if you like, don't be shy to subscribe, give me a thumbs up, and I will talk to you soon.